USA Today, USA Hockey Magazine, national polls. Not only are the Bobcats number one for the first time in program history, they're the first Quinnipiac team of any kind to attain a top national ranking in Division One. And joining me on the line is head coach Rand Pecknold. First off, Rand, thanks for the time, and once again, congratulations to you and the team.
Well, thank you very much. You know, we certainly appreciate it. It's been a great season so far, and we're certainly kind of soaking it in right now. As good as I thought we were going to be this year, I didn't think we'd be number one in the country. I mean, you have the Minnesotas and Michigans and Boston Colleges and Notre Dames of the world and Wisconsin's, et cetera. Like, it's pretty tough for a small school like us to kind of get up in that upper echelon. But, it's credit to the players. I mean, they've done a great job. We've had a great year. We've got some outstanding players. And credit to my staff. I mean, Billy Riga and Reed Cashman, Dan Myers, and our trainer, Brian Fairbrother, and our strength coach, Brijesh Patel, has been great, too. So we're thankful to all those guys for getting it done for us. And in the end, we still got some games to play, though. We got to play Friday night, so we got to get focused here.
No, I know. And you mentioned that, too, in your interview, a couple of your interviews. Yeah, you're soaking in the limelight. You got the job to do.
Absolutely, yeah. We already had a target on our back. I mean, we've been in first place, basically the whole year in our league, and been top 20 all season, and then all since top 15, top 10, top 5, then we're second for a while. So that target's been there for a while. Now it's just a little bit bigger, but, and that's made it tough, because every game we play, teams are fired up for us. You can't catch anybody napping, and it's a big event for every team that's playing us. So, but that's okay. We'll take it. It's what comes with having success. And I think our guys have handled it well. And we need to find a way to kind of get grounded a little bit here for our Friday game.
With me on the line is head coach Rand Pecknold, Quinnipiac men's hockey, and ranking number one. And as you mentioned before, early in the season, Quinnipiac was not ranked on either the national preseason poll. You remember those numbers, Rand?
Yeah. No, we didn't make the top 20 out of the gate. I don't think it took us long to get in there, but. Sometimes the polls are, the preseason polls, can't put a lot of weight in them. But, once you get in the season, and they get rolling, the voting's usually pretty good, pretty accurate, fairly accurate. I think more so than the poll is the pairwise, which is that's the computerized ranking. It takes a lot of different things into the equation. But that's, we've been number one in the pairwise, I think, for 4 or 5 weeks in a row. And that's actually how they pick the NCAA tournament, how they seed the NCAA tournament. And ultimately, the pairwise is much more important than the USA Today or the USCHO poll.
And we talk about that, your streak so far. We go back to Russell Goodman's golden overtime with that 3-2 win over Colgate.
Yeah, that was that got us rolling. We were struggling the first month of the season. We were 3-3-1. We'd kind of been up and down, and I was a little disappointed with our play. I thought we were selfish at times. I thought we had guys that were kind of, too individualistic and trying to do too much and trying to do one-on-one all over the ice. And, we have a good system. Obviously, it's proven now, but we've got a great system, a great group of guys, and we just had to get them to buy in. And that Goodman goal was, I think the key to our season. I mean, we had dominated Colgate that night. Colgate's a very good hockey team, and, we're out shooting them 37-10, and here we are in overtime. And I'm like, well, how does this happen? Like, we're dominated the game. We absolutely deserve to win that hockey game. And, Clay Harvey made a nice play to get the puck to the net, and Goody went and drove the net hard and hammered home 5-hole. That was a big win. We needed that win from a confidence standpoint, and, we've been off and running since then.
You better believe it, Rand, off and running, leading the offense with senior center Jeremy Langlois and protecting the goal with Eric Hartzell.
Yeah, it's a great team. Hartzell's been our best player. He's probably, the best player in our league right now and one of the best in college hockey. And, he's our backbone. And, Langer's been great, too. He's had an awesome year. I mean, he just has not taken a shift off all season. And, just a great compete level, great motor, and does everything for us. But, you can go on and on from there. There's so many good players, the Jones twins and, Matthew Pekka and a couple other guys that have stepped up to have really good years. Clay Harvey and Ben Arndt and Russ Goodman, we mentioned, and a couple sophomores and Bryce Van Braban and Danny Federico that have really elevated their game. But, the list goes on and on. Our D-Corps has been great. They don't kind of probably get the all the attention they deserve, but they've been really good. We've got, we're seven deep there. We've kind of rotated those seven guys to the six spots and, been very, very happy with them. And we got four seniors in that group who've been excellent.
309 wins in Division I, Rand. Outstanding.
Yeah, thank you on that. You know, we've that's some pretty good. I've done a good job of hiring good assistants, and we've had some good players here. That's, you know, that's the biggest part of it. You got to have some good players, and we have good players and good kids, and they'll win you a lot of hockey games.
And with six games remaining, the first of four, which are at home, looking forward to it coming up. The a pair of ECAC hockey contests when you're hosting St. Lawrence Friday and Clarkson on Saturday. How's the temperature in the rooms?
Well, you know, we got our work cut out for us. I mean, St. Lawrence is they're a good hockey team. They've got Greg Carey, who's the top goal scorer in the nation. He's a top point getter in the nation, and Kyle Flanagan, I believe, is third in points. So those two are just outstanding. And George Hughes, a defenseman who plays on that team, and he's outstanding too. All three of those guys have NHL potential, and you know, we're gonna have our hands full trying to shut them down. I think as a team, you know, we're deeper and we have a better team, but you know, those three guys can change a game, and if their goalie makes a few saves, you know, it's going to be a long night for us. But I think ultimately we need to get back to basics and do what we do well and really try to dictate the tempo of the game and play at pace and be good at what we're good at.
Well, Ram Pecknold, head coach, it's great to witness the evolution of the program here at Quinnipiac. Number one head coach, the Bobcats men's ice hockey. Look forward to it and looking forward to the tradition. You'll be able to hear the game this week on AM1220WQUN.com. But Ram Pecknold, once again, outstanding. Congratulations.
Thank you very much for having me on. I appreciate it.